My name is Anne Delehanty. I am in the French department, as well as in humanities and comparative literature.
I'm Alexei Ditter. I am a faculty member in the Chinese department.
I'm Naomi Caffee. I'm in the Russian department, as well as in the humanities program.
Yeah, hello. My name is Katja Garloff, and I'm teaching in the German department and in humanities.
Hi, my name is Monica Lopez Lerma, and I'm a faculty in the Spanish department.
I think my topic is first, namely placement exams. And about those, you just have to know two things. First of all, very importantly, they exist. And you're very much invited, if you have previously studied a language in high school or somewhere else, to take a placement exam or two, if you study two languages, in several departments, including German, Russian, and Chinese, I believe. These placement exams are also offered online over the summer. So you can take them then, or in any language, you can take a placement exam once you arrive here on campus during orientation week. The results are really not written in stone. They are more about finding the right fit for you. So don't feel like you're being tested or so. This is more a diagnostic tool for us. And if you feel you've been misplaced, like you either want to take a try out a higher class or go into a lower one and get a comprehensive review, most of the time the departments will accommodate that.
A good thing to know about our departments, so the departments represented here are Chinese, German, Spanish, Russian, and French, is that we all offer majors that combine both language study and literary study or film studies, you know, so cultural studies. So this is important because there are some schools where they have like business French or a kind of more linguistic focus on the language. We do have a linguistics major, so you can do that at Reed and spend a lot of time in the language departments, but all of the language departments at Reed have a focus in their upper division courses that are generally on literature or film or other kind of narrative type forms. So at Reed, we have what are called major planners, and the major planners will list out what's required for every major at Reed. And so that's a way for you to imagine what your 4 years would look like. And what's great about Reed, as well, it might look like we're just a French department, a Spanish department, a German department. In fact, all of us are none of that. All of us are much more than that. So we also have ad hoc majors that involve film studies, comparative literature, critical race and ethnic studies. And all of those are majors that might possibly engage with one of us in one of our departments. So I think it's important to look at those requirements. I will put a plug in for the language departments, the foreign literature departments, in that we all have pretty reasonable requirements for our majors, which is to say, if you choose to major in Spanish, French, German, Russian, Chinese, et cetera, you're gonna have room to take other courses as well. So one of the benefits of all of our majors is that there's room for electives. Now, obviously many of you have probably not studied some of these languages before. That particularly tends to be the case with Chinese and Russian. So there's gonna be some work to learn those languages, but we also, as we'll hear about, have study abroad and ways of learning it that's a little bit quicker. So what I would say the pluses of majoring in our departments are, and by our departments, I include also comparative literature, critical race and ethnic studies, film studies, and all of those, is that we are very, very small departments with tremendous amounts of interaction between students and faculty. So during your senior year, when you're working on the thesis, you'll be working one-on-one with a faculty, but in none of our departments is that the first time that you're working one-on-one with a faculty member. In all of our departments, we know our majors really, really well, and we work closely with them.
Yes, so as Anne sort of pointed out, one thing that is sort of a crucial part of study in the foreign languages is going to be maybe spending some time abroad. I mean, there's not much point to just study these things if you're never going to go to these places. So as it turns out, Reed has a lot of programs in support of various kinds of study abroad. We have partnerships with programs and colleges in 52 different universities across 23 different countries and territories, as well as partnerships with three other domestic colleges here in the United States. If you're interested in studying abroad, and I cannot stress this enough, you have to plan ahead, which means you need to think about where in the four-year program you're going to want to consider going abroad. You're going to want to consider where you want to go to study, and you want to consider what kinds of programs will be a best fit for the kinds of education you're looking for.
I'm going to be talking to you about minors at Reed. So minors are a relatively recent addition to the Reed curriculum. They've just come about in the past few years. We're excited to offer minors in several subjects, and most of the minors that are available are in the Division of Literature and Languages. So we have minors in modern languages available, Chinese, French, Spanish, German, and Russian. You can minor in classics or English, and then in another division, you can also minor in theater, dance, and we also have an interdisciplinary one of film and media studies. Typically, a minor is going to involve taking 5 or 6 courses in a department where a minor is offered. And the idea with that is that you get a substantial level of depth in that field of study.
I'm going to be talking about languages houses here at Reed. And language houses are on-campus dormitories that provide a great language-speaking environment for students from all departments who wish to speak one of the languages offered in the division. We have Spanish, Russian, French, German, Chinese, and Arabic language houses. Students have the opportunity to reside in private rooms in the houses, including a house advisor and 1 or 2 native speakers language scholars. As residents, you are not required to be fluent in the language that the house represents or to be enrolled in a course related to the language, but you need to demonstrate interest in learning about the culture and the language. So each language house hosts many cultural activities during the academic year, including screenings and discussion of films, poetry readings, creative writing contests, thematic parties, tutoring and conversation sessions. So these activities provide a wonderful opportunity for students across the college to enjoy many aspects of a specific culture as they practice their language skills in an informal setting.
So the nice thing about the sort of Chinese language study at Reed, we only require students to be able to write either simplified or traditional characters. We will require you to be able to read both. But if you can already sort of do one or the other, it's actually not too much trouble to start to figure out how to do the other.
At what point are classes taught in the target language? Are literature classes, do they require you to be fluent in that language or fluent enough to read in that language?
If you're looking in the course catalog, there's going to be courses listed as in the literature category, and those courses will be taught in English. But then if they are listed only in the language department, and it'll say, so all of our departments do offer courses that are taught only in the foreign language, only in the target language. And then many offer a number of courses that are in the discussions in English, but then have that extra hour. French and Spanish are kind of the outliers there, where most of our courses are taught in the language itself, but we, Spanish more so than French, are increasingly offering courses also that have that dual enrollment component.
Obviously, a lot of Reedies end up in academia, but can you talk a little bit about what else you've seen your students go on to do after Reed, after a language major?
All of us have the experience of students from all across the departments who come and take all across the majors who take our classes. For instance, I got an email a couple of years ago from a student who was a political science major, but took a ton of French. And she said, oh my gosh, I never thought I would be in the Peace Corps in Morocco with my French 210 textbook, reviewing the grammar structures because I just don't want to mess up and I just want to make sure that I'm clear in what I say. And so we have a whole bunch of students who end up doing amazing things using the languages that they learned at Reed. So I would also expand your question beyond the majors as well, that a lot of Reed students, I think, end up using foreign languages in their careers and using them productively.
Really many of our students, at least in the German department, go into fields that are broadly international, whether that's international law, business, and so on. I mean, that for some, studying a foreign language is for them a kind of an access into the global world.
Say, I'd also mention architecture is another field, but we do get a lot of sort of heavily sort of academic oriented, so also going on teaching or K-12 or higher education. But architecture was one, also working, you know, in business fields, Nike, a lot of international. There was a period of time, somewhat still now, but where a lot of firms that were doing business in China liked bringing in people who have a Chinese language training because they're going to give them sort of on the job training for what specifically they'll do as the job, but they need someone who can communicate effectively, is familiar with the environment, who's not going to, you know, be posted in China and suddenly just fall apart because they're not used to anything and they don't want to be there. So that was one area that we go.
So some of them are currently enrolled or have attended graduate or professional programs at places such as University of Chicago, Yale Law School, Goffman University, Johns Hopkins, University of Oregon, in Princeton University, and they are pursuing different degrees. Some of them are doing a PhD in Romance languages, or others are doing masters in teaching, or they are pursuing degrees in law and medicine. And some of the students also hold teaching and academic positions in Spanish department or teach Spanish in primary or secondary schools. Some of other students have become film directors or even immigration lawyers. So there is a large variety of options that after read doing a Spanish major here.